to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I am the bread of life. This is one of the formulas of self-revelation by Jesus. This statement is a self-definition. I am. It is a self-definition. It is a self-revelation. I am the bread of life. In the Gospel of John, there are several self-definitions of the Lord. Aside from saying, I am the bread of life, Jesus also said, I am the light of the world. I am the door of the sheep pen. I am the good shepherd. I am the resurrection and the life. I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the true vine. You are the branches. These are self-revelations. These are self-descriptions. These are self-definitions. I am and no one else is, or I and I alone, it is I who am. This is what the Lord wants to tell us. My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel reading for today comes from chapter 6 of the Gospel of John. Chapter 6 of the Gospel of John is known as the chapter on the discourse on the bread of life. If you want to know, if you want to learn, if you want to review what the Lord said about the bread of life, you can give yourself a little assignment by reading the whole chapter, chapter 6 of John, known as the discourse on the bread of life. The Gospel of John may be divided into two major subdivisions. The first part of the Gospel of John is known as the Book of Signs. The second part of the Gospel of John is known as the Book of Glory. What do we mean when we say that the first part of the Gospel of John is known as the Book of Signs? It means these are the events, often called signs or miracles, that are used as evidence that Jesus is God and that Jesus is from God. What are the seven signs in the Book of Signs? Number one, water is changed into wine at Cana. Number two, the healing of a royal official's son. Number three, the woman caught in adultery. Number four, the multiplication of the bread and the feeding of the 5,000. Number five, walking on the water and Jesus presenting himself as the true bread from heaven. Number six, the healing of a man born blind because Jesus is the light of the world. And number seven, the raising of Lazarus. These are proofs or evidence that Jesus is God and that Jesus is from God. How about the Book of Glory? What do we mean when we say that the second part of the Gospel of John is the Book of Glory? It simply means that the second part, the second half of John's Gospel, is the narrative of the glorification of Jesus through crucifixion and resurrection. What are the seven items in the Book of Glory? The washing of the feet, the foretelling of the betrayal by Judas Iscariot, the new commandment of love and Peter's denial, the promise to send the Holy Spirit, arrest in the garden, the trial before Pontius Pilate, the crucifixion and death, the resurrection at the Sea of Tiberias, his appearance in discussion with Peter. So these are the two major parts of the Gospel of John. Let us go to what the crowd said to Jesus in the gospel today. Give us this bread always. Give us this bread always. Give us this bread from now on. In Greek, it is pantote, which simply means always, meaning to say they are requesting for a continual, a lifetime supply of bread. My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus gives us unlimited supply of this bread. The supply is endless. The supply is unending. The supply is non-stop. The supply is 24/7, 365 days a year. It is uninterrupted. It is all the time. It is forever. Every time we celebrate the Eucharist, this is the same bread that Jesus gives to the people during his time. This is the same bread that we will tell Jesus, Sir, Lord, Master, give us this bread as often as possible, as frequently as we could, because this is the food for the journey. The bread of life is the food for the journey. The bread of life is the medicine of immortality. The bread of the Eucharist is the bread of angels. It is panis angelicus. My dear brothers and sisters, my attraction to the priesthood is started with an attraction to the Eucharist. I fell in love with the priesthood because I also fell in love with the Eucharist. I realized that if there is no Eucharist, there is no priest. And if there is no priest, there is no Eucharist. If there is no Eucharist, there is no priest. And there is no priest without the Eucharist. Amen.